Okay, now we move to the second subtopic, which is kinematic of particle. But now we look into the curvilinear motion. Previously, we looked into the rectilinear motion, motion in a straight line. Now we look into the curvilinear motion, motion which involves more than one axis. Okay, to begin with, we look into the another subtopic, which is on the rectangular coordinates. Okay. Okay. Just look at it. This one. Okay. The snowboarder and the train both undergo curvilinear motion. As you can see, the snowboarder jump and will sort of fly. Okay, jump and then make a curve path, okay, before it lands down here. The same thing here for the train. It goes through a steep corner, like so. Okay, a particle moving along a curve other than a straight line, it is a curvilinear motion. Simple as that. Okay, the position vector of a particle at time t is defined by a vector between origin at point O of a fixed reference frame. Fixed reference frame, what we have here is this axis here. X, Y, and Z. Okay, this is our fixed reference frame and the position occupied by the particle. Particle at point P and at point P prime. Okay, consider a particle which occupies position P here, defined by vector r, distance r at time t. So from here to here, at this particular instant it is time t, and then moving on to the next point, which is p prime, and it is defined by r delta r, or here I put it r prime, vector r prime at time t plus delta t. Okay, this one r prime, so t plus delta t. Okay, so for the instant velocity vector, it is of course a vector. You have a head up here, arrow, so it is can be represented like this. And for the scalar, or just we call it as speed, okay, vector we call it velocity, scalar we call it speed. So for the speed, we rather use s, distance. So ds over dt, there is no arrow up here, or sometimes on certain books they prefer to use instead of v with a head like this, v. They come up with a different shapes like a head, or they also can normally use bolt. Okay, so V is the font of this particular V is a bolt. Okay, to represent that it is a vector, so it depend on their preference. Okay, consider velocity v of a particle at time t and velocity v at v prime at t plus t or t plus delta t, and then we have a v prime and v, so therefore we can say that we have a certain amount of acceleration, because v is no longer fixed or no longer constant. They have a two value of v, so therefore we have a instantaneous acceleration, and you can represent it like this. However, in general, the acceleration vector is not tangent to the particle path and velocity vector. Okay, remember, in general, okay, sometimes, okay, in general, the acceleration vector is not tangent to the particle path. For example, like this one, you can see that v is going that way, but the acceleration is going, the rate here, going upwards in that direction. So sometimes be in the same direction, sometimes they don't. Okay? Depend case by case. Okay, when position vector of P is given by its rectangular component, okay, like this, the reference frame, the position can be represented by like this. So in the X, we have XI, in the Y, we have YJ, and in the Z, we have a Z and a K. Okay, for the velocity, it's the same process. Okay, we took the ddt of each of the position vector in the I, j and k. So we end up with x dot I, y dot j and z dot k, or you can change it into this expression where we have bx, by and bz. The same process for the acceleration vector, you do from this one, okay, then you can arrive with ax, ay and az, the same thing. Okay, for the rectangular component, particularly effective when component acceleration can be integrated independently, motion of a projectile, for example, where from this particular example, we can see that the AX, okay, acceleration in the X direction is equal to zero, where however we have only have acceleration in the Y, okay, because we have a gravity. In the Z, of course, Z is pointing going up of this particular page, so nothing to do with Z actually. Okay, with initial condition, start from point 0, 0, 0, so X not, Y not, Z not, all of them are zero. And also for the velocity, it's also zero. Integrating twice, okay, integrating twice, what we can have is this particular formula. So Vy, you can express as Vy naught minus Gt, and Y, and from here, Y you can integrate. Then you get this Vy naught times Y minus half Gt square. Just do the math. Okay. Motion in horizontal direction is uniform. Motion in vertical direction is uniformly accelerated, okay, because of the G. Motion of a projectile could be replaced by two independent rectilinear motion. So, can see like this. Moving on to the second example. Okay, we need to determine the speed at which the basketball at A must be thrown at an angle of 30 degrees so that it makes it to the basket at B. Okay, there is one guy here throwing this basketball, and it at the hand or the ball is actually 1.5 meter measured from this ground, and it is thrown at an angle of 30 degrees pointing to this basket here. So we can use this formula where S is equal to S naught plus V naught P. So we know that for the first calculation, we look into the X component of this particular problem. So S and S naught are referred to the distance measured in the X direction. So S is this one up to here. Okay. So S naught is here. So S is from here to here. So it is 10 meter. And then VA is this component here. And we know that For the X component, that direction, it is cos 30 degrees. Okay. And then just multiply by T like so. And for the second part, we look into the Y component. Okay. For the Y component is here. Initially, it was at the height of 1.5 meter. So S naught is 1.5. And you see that at point B, we know that the height is 3 meter. Okay, that's why it is 3 meter. So previously, we look into the X direction, but now we look into the Y direction. And VA, the V component, in the Y direction, it is a sine 30 degrees. It's just a trigonometry. And then you plus by half AC times T square. Actually, on this particular equation, you also can include this part. Okay? Half AC times T square. You can also include. However, there is no acceleration involved. And therefore, this term, even though it is appear here, it becomes zero because AC is equal to zero on this part, this equation up here. However, on this part, because we deal with Y direction, we have the component of gravity. So AC is not equal to zero. AC is equal to minus 9.81 because the gravity is pointing downwards. Therefore, we have a minus sign here. And T is equal to 0.9334 second. And we do the maths and can calculate the T. And then, from this equation, we have the first equation. Let's say this is equation number one, and this one is, it is equation number two. And from the equation number one, we have two unknowns, which is VA and T. And on the second equation, we have also two unknowns, the same unknown actually, VA and T. And therefore, we have two equations, two unknowns, so we can solve for T and VA like so. Thank you.